Hey Christos, I'm a .NET developer. Can you show me how do I secure a brand new app using an identity provider?
Absolutely. Now, you don't have to be it doesn't have to be a brand new application, but the code that we'll show you should be applicable to anything that is .NET Core 3 or later. So okay. The easiest way to get started is let's do a greenfield project, so .NET new web app. I can't even type. And then we'll do --auth just to signify that we want to use authentication. And then we'll do single org, which is the Azure Active Directory tenant that we want to use. Now, at this point, it will create a template, but there's no configuration. Let's open this in code and see what we have. I'm using .NET 6, by the way, so it's all the latest and greatest. And in here, we're going to go into the app settings. There's a lot of things that we need to fill in here. But the main code is here. Let's hide that. On line 10, yes. On line 11 and 12, we're saying, I want to use authentication and I want to secure a web app. And it pulls the section from Azure AD in the config. Then we have a default authorization policy, which in effect tells our application, you need to authorize any user that comes to this app. The first thing they have to do is sign in. If you don't sign in, you can't go anywhere. And then we apply that with use authentication and use authorization. From a code perspective, this is all you need to do to get started. Now we just need to jump very quickly to the portal to actually create an app registration that will work with our application. So here I'm using my Microsoft Developer tenant. If you don't have a tenant, I would urge you to go to the Microsoft 365 Developer Program and sign up. You get a P2 or a P1. You get a P1 Azure Active Directory for free to use, including data, OneDrive, SharePoint, and what have you, plus some dummy users, which makes your life a lot easier. You don't have to mess with your IT team and ask them for permissions. You'd be a god managing this Azure AD tenant. And that's what I do for most of my demos. So here we're going to create a new app registration. You go to app registrations, you click new registration.
So then
go for it.
The app registration, I'm sorry, I kind of cut you. The app registration for everybody, that's kind of the new, that taking place to the app user password that we used to do back in the day, right?
Yeah, so for us, there are two things that you need to do when you start with Microsoft Identity. One, or in fact, with any identity provider, it doesn't have to be the Microsoft Identity provider, but you have to create an registration, an application. So if you ever use Twitch or Twitter or anything else to authenticate users, you need to go there in the developer portal and create an app registration or registration. This in effect tells the platform that you're going to use that to authenticate users, either OpenID Connect or OAuth2 if you need to get some access tokens.
Okay.
That's exactly what we're doing here. An app registration inside Azure Active Directory signifies to the directory that we're going to be using it to authenticate our users. So if we go back to the screen, I'll give it a name. I'm saying I'm only going to sign in users for my directory. I'll leave everything else blank. So I will press register. And then in here, we have some important information. So we want the application ID to pass back to our code. Is that the right one? Yeah, that's the right one. So app settings, we have to add the client ID. And then we need a tenant ID, which I need to capture again from the portal. So switching here, that's our directory or tenant ID. We will add this here as well. I will add the domain name, which is my name because I am bane.onmicrosoft.com. And I'm leaving everything else as they are. I need to make sure that I press save because otherwise it won't work. I'll also remove the comments because I hate the squiggles. So let's save again. And now all I need to do is just finish up inside Azure Active Directory in our app registration. We need to say what is signing in or how we're signing in. We need to add a platform. So it's a web app. It's a server-side web app. And our redirect URI, this is where we expect to receive our ID tokens. This is where Azure Active Directory will send back the tokens or the code for the OAuth flow. And if that's wrong and doesn't match our application, then this is where things fall apart. So localhost, because we're running locally using Kestrel, localhost, and then 5001, that's our default port. And then OIDC, I forgot. And you can find that, which is also a good way to sign in OIDC. There you go, that one. I need more coffee this morning. Okay. And then we'll press save and run it. Should be it here. Sign in OIBC. OIBC. We need to click on those and configure. That's all we need. So now if we go back to our app or the console, you know, we can use the console. Unless that's the right one. So .NET excludes and .NET run. Will it work?
So we configure the portal. Huh? We now, when we brought the identifier in our config app, and now we're building, so two of them should talk to each other.
Oh, what? Look, .NET 6 has added random ports there, which I didn't realize. So now, remember how I said that things will not work if we don't have them configured properly? Then it's 7254. Thank you, .NET 6, for adding this nice twist over there. So 7254 was it, right? 7254. Save.
Not my. I'm sure there's a good reason why it's that. Maybe because you run it parallel or something like that.
Is it?
I don't know.
I haven't run the RC yet, so that's the first time I'm actually testing the RC. So this is going to be a good test. So let's browse. Okay, that's a good step. Good. Permissions requested, and because I'm already signed in, it's actually going into and we signed in. There you go. Few seconds.
Wonderful. That was easy. So just like that, we can get started with .NET and securing your app. Well, thank you. And now it's time for the question in the chat.